so many people live streaming today that it's really difficult to get on. It told me that too many people are live streaming. So hello, welcome to Pajama Party Q&A. I am still wearing my pajamas, of course. I have some really excellent slippers on. I'm going to show you. Can you see my old man slippers? Oh, I'm not stretchy enough. I can't show you my slippers. But they're really excellent. Hello. Hello to everyone joining. Hello. How are you all doing? Are you all good? It has been the weirdest week. It's been a really difficult week. I hope everyone is doing okay. It has been really odd and nuts. So I hope everyone is okay. Hello, Pink Julie 15. I hope you're going well. So we've been absolutely inundated with questions over the last few days, which is really lovely. So I'm really looking forward to going through lots of them with you. Thank you so much for joining us. Very excited to be here. Very excited we were finally able to get on Instagram Live. I will kick us off. I'm Evie, by the way. I should have said that. I'm Evie Fehilly. I am your host for the Shush Pajama Party Q&A. And as we go, if you do have any questions, just write them in the comments or like DM them to Shush, and we can, if we can't get around to answering them now, we will get, hello, Johanna, we will get around to answering them a little bit later and maybe in another one of the Q&As. So welcome. I hope everyone is doing well. And I also have a quarantini with me. You see? Mm-hmm. Sorry, which I just got everywhere. What is the best-selling sex toy of all time for Shush? That is an interesting question because there's lots of different categories of sex toy, and so it's the different ones have sold really well at different times. One that I don't have with me, which is the waterproof rabbit, is a sex toy that is absolutely brilliant, and it was actually discovered by Shush. The rabbit vibrator is not something many people know, but it was discovered by Shush. It was found at the back of a sex toy warehouse somewhere, and Kai, who founded Shush, sort of remade it slightly and marketed it as the rabbit we know and love today. I haven't got that toy with me, but we will link it later in one of the stories. I've got a couple of other of our best-selling sex toys. This is the little lipstick vibrator. This is a really, really popular sex toy. No, of course, Johanna, I don't mind joining at all. Well, everyone's welcome. So this is a little lipstick vibrator. So it's a really, really buzzy bullet vibrator. I'm going to get my friend Rosie here, who's a little vulva puppet, who's going to join us, so I can just show you how you would use a bullet vibrator. Bullet vibrator is really, really good for pinpointing sensation. I wouldn't use it directly on the clitoris that much, but you can use it going up and down the labia lips. As I say, just really pinpointing sensation as opposed to it being a much bigger sensation. This is the toy that does much more bigger sensations, so fuller vulva sensations with this kind of toy. This is a pebble. This is another best-selling toy at Shush. What's really lovely about this toy is you can just place it on the vulva and you get wider vulva sensation. So as I was saying with the bullet, it's pinpointing sensation. With the pebble, you can actually place it on the vulva and it's just stimulating more of the vulva at once. You can still use it in the same way, sort of going up and down the labia lips and working your way round. Hello, hello, hello. Working your way round the vulva. So you can still use it like that, but it just gives you a wider range of sensation as well. Okay, so they are some of the best-selling sex toys. Oh, there's one more. This one is for penises. So this one I talked about a little bit on the last Q&A. So this is a tenga egg. So I'm going to show you what a tenga egg is. It comes in these little egg cup things, and it is a toy for penises. On, and it is the easiest hand job you'll ever give. Oh yeah, that's a tenga egg. It's a very, very fun toy, and it's incredibly easy to use, and we sell so many of them. It's not a forever toy, so you just wash it out, you turn it inside out, wash it out, let it air dry. It's got these different cool sort of silicon patterns on the inside, which are really fun, but it will break eventually. It just sort of depends how But that's what a tenga egg is, and they are really, really popular. So something for the vagina owners and something for the penis owners. Ah, that's a really great thing. I'm being assisted today by the wonderful We Nude to Talk, and she has just reminded me that if you want to go on the website and order anything, we are still delivering, we are still open, use the code virtual and you get 15% off. And all of the stuff I'm mentioning is all the stuff we have in the shop as well. Okay, so our second question is, my partner is still a little unsure when it comes to toys and I get no private time. I don't even have children. Are there any good toys for moments that I can steal to myself? This is a really interesting question. And what I really want to know is, sort of, do you want something in the moments that you steal to yourself? Does this mean you want something quiet? Or does this mean you want something quick? Or does this mean you want something that isn't going to intimidate your partner? So, I've got a few things that I've thought of. So in terms of things being quick, the Satisfy definitely leads the game in this. I'm going to talk a little bit more about the Satisfy later. There's been lots of questions about the Satisfy. But so the Satisfy is an incredibly quick toy. I have a friend who used one who texted me afterwards, or text my friend saying, holy shit, 30 seconds. And so it can be a very, very quick toy. It doesn't work for everyone, but it is hugely popular and works for a lot of people. It is a suction toy, so it sucks and blows as opposed to vibrating. So it's a little bit different, but it is a very quick toy. So if it was about just stealing those moments, then that would be a really good one. Or maybe it's about it being quiet, so it's nice and subtle, and which there's quite a few that are quite quiet. The finger tingles is a really great toy for that. It's a really, really lovely toy. It looks like some kind of funky bottle opener from IKEA, but what it is a vibrator that goes on your finger like a little ring, and it makes your finger vibrate. So rather than using the toy, although you could use the toy, you can use your finger actually as a vibrator. It becomes a vibrator, so you're keeping that skin-to-skin contact. It's really quiet, so you can steal off and no one would know what you were doing. But also it is, you're just keeping that skin-to-skin contact. It's a great one to use with a partner if they maybe are a little bit intimidated about toys or they're not sure about them. Because you're keeping the skin-to-skin, it just makes things a little bit easier. Because it doesn't look like a traditional sex toy, it looks really, really non-threatening, non-intimidating. It's a really good one to use for that sort of thing. I have thought of another toy that's kind of the other end, which is more of the like quick getting the job done, which is a wand toy. So these are big, big clitoral toys. This is not a quiet toy. This is very much more if you're looking for something to just have a quick session on your own. Now, wand vibrators are incredibly strong vibrators. They were originally developed as back massagers and by Hitachi, so it was the Hitachi magic wand. And then they found out what people were actually using them for, which was putting them on their clitorises, as we all know now. But this would be a great toy if you just have a few moments to yourself and you want to get something that gets the job done quickly, wham, bam, thank you, ma'am, then this would be a really, really great toy for you. It is not a quiet toy at all. God, no, it isn't. What's that to? Oh, let me know. I'm going to go on to our next question. I'm trying to think, there was another vibe that came to my mind of something that is really, really non-intimidating, doesn't look like a traditional sex toy, or something that maybe if someone is threatened by a sex toy, I often think it's about what they have in mind, what they think of. Someone asked about wands. Are they only plug-ins? So this one is a plug-in wand. The most powerful ones tend to be plug-in wands, but there is also the O wand, which is a non-plug-in wand. We have a Shush plug-in wand and non-plug-in wand. So it's quite good. Vegan Natural Beauty, it's not quiet. No, you're absolutely right. No, that was the wands were very much for the like a quick session as opposed to a quiet session. Slightly different things, I wonder, but you're absolutely right, it's not a quiet toy. But this little macaroon, I thought was something like really subtle, really non-intimidating, something you could use and maybe your partner wouldn't be too freaked out by. So that might be something to incorporate in as well. Cool, I'm going to go on to our next question. I thought this was a really amazing question. I shouldn't say that. I think all the questions are brilliant. And with these Q&As, like, please feel free to ask whatever questions you want to ask. I think, especially when it comes to sex education and sex in general, there are no stupid questions. So please feel free to ask whatever. I promise you, we will never judge you at Shush. Just ask whatever you want to ask. Apart from, we do sometimes get, do you sell women? Which, no, we don't. Don't ask that question. Everything else is up for grabs. I got this great question. Hey, I'm 21 and I got my first bullet vibrator about a year ago. I love it, but now I'm bored with it. I was thinking about getting another one to add some more good vibes, but I think I need some more penetrative vibes for my G-spot as I'm horny for dick, which I think is the funniest question. I love it. I like to think of that as a stuck in dick sound. This person is asking for recommendations. So I was thinking about a couple of things. So if you have a bullet vibrator, a suggestion of mine would be to maybe incorporate a glass toy with it. I know you're talking about vibes for G-spots as well. But what can be a really, really great thing is if you want something for your G-spot, my absolute favourite thing for the G-spot is a glass toy. The G-spot loves firmer textures, so like glass, stone, metal. Something about the weight of it and the texture of it that the erectile cylinders of the G-spot, it really responds to that. So a glass toy can be really great for that. And so if you put a glass toy in like that, just about 2 to 3 centimeters up the vaginal canal and found the G-spot and kind of juiced your G-spot, and then with a clitoral vibrator as well, that's a really amazing combination. So if you're a bit bored of your bullet, then maybe that's a way you can combine the two. I absolutely love glass toys so much. They are so fun and you can use them in loads of different ways. With this one, you can use either end of it. You can heat it up, you can cool it down. It is such a cool toy. And it might be something just to spice up that clit vibrator that you're not so fond of anymore. Another thought of a G-spot toy that I'm very in love with at the moment, this is the Zalo Queen. This is a really beautiful toy and it has loads of different things that it does. So you might be able to hear it. Can you see it, I wonder? So it's doing a little tapping motion. So this one, it does have a vibrating session setting. It has lots of different settings. And it's also, it has a sort of like tapping motion, it vibrates. It can also heat up as well, which is just incredible. And it's a really well-shaped vibrator for a G-spot as well. You see that kind of curve? That's perfect for the G-spot. So you would pop that in. I'm going to get Rosie back. I'm going to pop that in just to there. Then do a sort of juicing motion upwards and you're just taking advantage of that little curve here, so this little juicing motion up like that. What is also amazing about the Zalo Queen is it's super fashionable, comes with this little cape as well, and so you can put this little cape on, you put a little bit of lube inside it and then pop the cape on, and then you have one of the suction toys, so the ones I was talking about like this, that don't vibrate so much, but they suck and blow. But this, with its fancy little cape, if you then put on that tapping setting that I had on before, it creates the suction effect. So it does everything. It's a really, really cool toy. I'm gonna let it take a little bow now. A little bow toy. It's an amazing toy. Cool, so I hope that answers your question about either a new G-spot toy, the Zalo Queen is incredible, but also if you want to use your old bullet, just ways to spice it up with using, maybe incorporating one of the beautiful glass toys, or just a toy that maybe doesn't vibrate, maybe a stone toy, a metal toy, that sort of juicing motion with the G-spot combined with a vibrating toy for the clitoris is really, really incredible. We're going to put all of the links in the toy, we're going to put all the toys I've chatted about, I'm going to put them in the story. So this red one is the Zayla Queen, and I have completely forgotten how much it is in the store. We need to talk, could you let me know? But we're going to link all of them. So our next question is about the Satisfyer Pro that I was talking about. So I've recently bought a Satisfyer Pro, which is this wonderful, wonderful toy, but have struggled to achieve the desired effect. Do you have any tips? So this toy, I could write love letters to it. I absolutely love it. I know loads of people that love it, but not everyone. We are all completely different. Our bodies are completely different. They respond in different ways. So of course, it's not going to work for everyone. But I recommend that you try, and you can try a few different things. It is a toy that I would recommend applying directly to the clitoris. That is not something I say that often. I talk a lot in my job about finding different ways to stimulate the clitoris that is indirect, because those nerve endings get oversensitized so quickly that actually I recommend some indirect stimulation. But with this one, you can go directly for the clitoris, and because it's not directly touching it, the air sort of swirls around it, sucks around it, and it can give you really intense sensation, but without actually overstimulating those nerve endings. So what I would recommend, if you have found that you put it on directly and that feels maybe a bit too much, or it just doesn't feel quite right, then I would recommend like playing around, like put it directly on your clitoris, see how that feels, and then change the position of it, playing with the labia lips as well. Remember, this is the full structure of the clitoris, or something similar to this. This is a very symmetrical version, but this clitoris runs down the labia legs. So I've run out of hands to show you all of these things. But it runs down the labia legs. So you can play with the Satisfyer, you can play with your labia as well, and you will still be stimulating the clitoris. So playing with it in different positions. I bang on about lube all the time, but lube is incredible. Add lube to your routine if you haven't already. And so if you find maybe the Satisfyer is a little bit uncomfortable, lube might do absolute wonders for you. So just adding that in with the Satisfyer could work really well. You could also try as well, it's a completely waterproof toy. You could also try using it in the shower, using it in the bath. That might change things a little bit. But good luck, it's an amazing toy. So I would try and press on if you can and see if you can work through it. The wonderful Renee and the wonderful We Need to Talk are putting lots of prices down here for everyone for what we talked about, but I think we're also going to link them in our stories as well. Okay, so what else do we have? We have a question also about vacuum vibes. So I'm intrigued by the vacuum vibes, but curious to know how the sensations compare to the standard bullets. So again, this is one of the vacuum vibes. As we were talking about the Zayla Queen earlier as well, that creates a vacuum. A vacuum vibe, the same sensation, similar sensation. How do they compare to bullets? This is really tricky to answer. Because I think that's slightly personal as well. I think all people will feel it slightly differently. But I suppose the bullet is much more direct sensation, and the suction toys, they will suck air around the clitoris. They are really intense though. I actually find them more intense in a way than vibrations. The suction toys, just a little bit more intense. It's a very different feeling. Sometimes it can feel like there's more pressure on it. That can really help with lube. But it is a different feeling. Sometimes it feels a lot more intense than vibrations, as I was saying. So I would sort of try it for a little bit and then take it off again. This is a really useless answer to what does it feel like. It feels really great. and it works really, really quickly. But it is a different feeling to vibrations. Just sometimes can feel more intense. I feel like I answered that very circularly, but I hope that answers your question in some way. The next question is, I'm thinking about getting a strap on for when Gal and I are able to see each other again, but after isolation. Bum butt. This is how it's written. Wonderful. Bum butt. I don't know where to start and what to buy, as I have never used one and neither has she. So, this is a really great question. It's a big question. How to buy your first strap-on. It's like buying the third in your relationship. So I would recommend not to buy a set. I think sets can sometimes be tricky because they're not quite right for you. So often you can buy, what I mean by a set is that the harness comes with the dildo, so they are together and you can't change them out. So I would recommend not buying a set strap-on, so buying something where the dildo and the harness is separate. This way you have a lot more choice, a lot more flexibility. A really great thing to do is come down to Shush, of course. Well, we can't come down to Shush at the moment, but if you go on the website, there are loads of different harnesses and loads of different dildos. And I think having the different, being able to buy them separately means that you can tailor it much more to you and your partner or your partners. So what I would suggest is always do this with your partner. It should always be the person who is going to be penetrated that chooses the dildos, and it should always be the person who is going to be wearing the harness to choose the harness. But it's a really fun thing to do together. It's a really, really great way to start the conversation off. It can be really sexy. It can be a really enjoyable trip to go and do, or at the moment to go and sit on the website. And then you can really start that conversation and find out what you find sexy within the world of strap-ons. We tend to measure our dildos, our wonderful dildos that we make at Shush on site. We make these ourselves. So these wonderful dildos we tend to measure with a spaghetti measurer when we're in the shop. And the spaghetti measurer goes up in how many fingers. So we do them, so if you feel comfortable with one finger inside, then stick with a dildo with one finger. Two fingers, stick with a dildo that is about the width of two fingers. Three fingers, do the same. So this one I'd say is about two fingers in width. So if you are comfortable with just two fingers inside, that is absolutely fine, but stick with something that is about two fingers and then work your way up if you want to. And that is just important so that you're comfortable with whatever is being used with the strap on. So it's just about making sure you get the right size and the right shape. If you have a look on the website, we have loads of different sizes and shapes of dildos. So it's about everything, about sort of just finding out what textures you want and what size and shape and girth that you will enjoy. And so there are also the harness elements. So, the dildo will go in the harness like this, if anyone hasn't done that before. Looking very fine there. So harnesses look way more complicated than they actually are, I promise you. So you really do just pop them on like pants, one leg either side. And then harnesses, it's about working out what you want in terms of material. Again, these are made on site at Shush. These are made from Nappa leather, which is a really, really lovely soft leather. And this one has a really, really lovely support. So this is a really, really lovely one if you have maybe any back problems. It just gives you that little bit more support. Or even if you don't, it's a really, really comfortable one. But if you have a little look on the Shush website, as we said, it's virtual is the code for 15% off. And have a look at all the different harnesses. There's loads of different harnesses to choose from. And that's all about A, what you like the look of and what you find really sexy. And B, it's just about, like, as I say, what level of support you need. This is the super harness. Thank you. We need to talk. And this is the whirly-girly. We have a range of whirly-girlies of different shapes and sizes. Well, not different shapes, this shape. And sizes to choose from. Cool, I hope that answers your question about buying your first strap-on. So my big takeaways would be, do it together so that you both know what you're going for. Make sure the person who is being penetrated chooses the dildo and the person who is wearing the harness chooses the harness, so you're comfortable doing that. And then also think about what are you comfortable with in terms of fingers in order to choose your dildo. I hope that makes some sense. I hope that answered your question. Oh, we do have also lovely add-ons on the website. Things like this. And this actually straps into the dildo so that with this little amazing device, you you thread it down the back of the harness, sorry, and then you pop in another dildo, and then you could have that attached to the harness, and it could be inside the person doing the penetration. So this is just another way of adding something fun and exciting, if that's what you want to do. Okay, the next question is another wonderful question, as they all have been. Pegging, let us know all about it. Okay, so pegging is I think pegging, the word pegging was coined by Dan Savage and his listeners. And pegging is a female-bodied person often anally penetrating a male-bodied person with a strap-on. Sorry, you're absolutely right. No need to talk. This is a dual dildo strap-on accessory. Thank you. Yeah, so pegging is anal penetration with a strap-on, so with a harness and a dildo. It is a lot of fun. Lots of really, really popular. It has become a lot more popular in the last few years as it has become more socially acceptable for male-bodied people to want to explore prostate stimulation. You want to go for slightly different dildos when looking at pegging or for anal play in general. This is actually a really good dildo for pegging because it is a little bit longer and it is bendier. You want something that is nice and bendy. In terms of vaginal play, you tend to be able to go for something a little bit thicker and always start with something thinner for pegging. For any kind of harness play or any so strap-on play or just using a harness, want to think about how much length you're gonna miss, because if you think about it, once this is inside a strap-on, once you take into account bellies and bums, you only have so much playable length left. So some people want to start with like a really, really small dildo because they're a little bit worried about it, which is a great idea. It's great to start small, but I tend to suggest start small in terms of girth, but go a little bit longer, because just with harness and bodies and things, will lose a little bit of that length, so it's just a good thing to do. So yeah, pegging is a lot of fun. I'm trying to think of any other hot tips. Use loads of lube with pegging, really, really important. It's not a self-lubricating area. With any kind of anal play, use a lot of lube. I suggest some lubes. A great lube for anal play would be Pure Plus. That would be my go-to record. Cool, I'm going to move swiftly on to the next question. So this question is, I choke when giving blowjobs and my gag reflex is terrible. Help! So, great question. So there are a few things you can do. So some people swear by grabbing your thumb, stops your gag reflex, grabbing your thumb like that, or sort of pushing into your diaphragm, stopping your gag reflex. Works for some people, not for everyone. I'd also say doing something at Shush we like to call cock yoga, where you breathe in as you take something into your mouth and you breathe out as you take it out. Sort of going with your airwaves allows a little bit more space and makes it a little bit easier. But I would say in general, when giving head to a penis, this part of the penis up here, this is covered in lube, it isn't just really shiny from the tango egg, just FYI. So this part of the penis is by far the most sensitive part of the penis. So this has around 4,000 nerve endings on it. So this part is really where it's at, and that's where you need to really focus on. So don't put too much pressure on yourself to be like slinging it back in your throat. That is something that has really come from porn, like a lot of deep throating. That's not to say if you don't enjoy deep throating, then that's great and you're good at it. But if you really hate it and you have a really sensitive gag reflex, do not put loads of pressure on yourself to just like sling it back in your throat, because it can be really unpleasant and it can be quite painful. And porn stars are athletes. We've all got to remember that. They are athletes. They do this for a living. We shouldn't expect ourselves to do the things that they are doing all the time. So do not feel like you need to be deep throating all the time and saying off your gag reflex if that's something that's really sensitive for you. So don't worry too much about it. But as I say, breathing in goes in, breathing out as it goes out, you'll find you can take a little bit more each time. Positioning also helps, like if you kind of hang your head off a bed and make your Cool. So I think this is our last question for this evening. Sexting during lockdown. Oh, I should say as well about that, thank you, we need to talk. So blow his mind, the class is next Wednesday. We're going to try a Zoom class, I think, or maybe a Google Hangout class. So I miss teaching my classes really desperately, so please come and join me. So I'll just be talking about sex on my own. I think we're doing it next Wednesday, April the 1st, and it will be on the website. So tickets are on the website. As I say as well, you can get a discount for any toys and things that you want to buy. The discount code is virtual. Cool. So I think this is our last question, unless anyone has anything. So sexting during lockdown, do you contact an old booty call? Yes. Why not? Yes. I don't know if I could say anything else about that. Are they good at bed? Are they good at sexting? Think about those things. Will it be complicated if you do contact them? There are things to ask, but yes, we're getting lots of yeses here. Yes, contact them. Good luck. I mean, sexting is definitely the way to get through isolation. This is an amazing toy. This is a Wii Vibe Sync. This is a toy called a teledildonic. It is an app-controlled sex toy. So, I mean, you could go way further than just texting your old booty call. You could get yourself one of these.